Good morning everyone and welcome to the Two-Headed Wolf Gaming Channel as we are continuing our journey through Darkest Dungeon 2. I still have a cold, however, I'm almost out of the woods. So without further ado, let's see what we will do today. We need to avoid the Hoarder, which means that we cannot take the left side path towards the hospital and we cannot take the middle path either. We have to go to the right. And that's what we will do. We have three battles coming up, or two, and the lair. I might push the lair at least twice. We'll see if we have the capabilities to take on the boss. But that will not be our goal. Our goal is farming. What do we do here? Everybody agrees that we should fight? Well, in a way. Except for the leper. But we will fight, and we will fight also by keeping them vulnerable, which is great because they are sturdy enemies. So who do we take on first? I will leave the Lord for last because he has a lot of health. I am just gonna go for this lost soul because he is ordained. That's the name I was looking for.
Repulsive as it is.
I could do one of these Abyssal Artilleries, or I could draw him to the front. I guess Abyssal Artillery is good enough. A beautiful crit on the Lord. Interesting. We'll do withstand just to attract some of the damage here. And we'll throw a bomb on this lost soul with another crit there. He might die. Painful breath. Okay, that gave us one weakness. And I do a point blank shot here, a 21 to 27 hit. That was quite good there. But I will need to clear out these corpses. Let's throw a bomb first of all in the back. And we are going to try to pull him just so we can clear the corpses. He has a combo trigger now on him. We even have a crit, and because he has a combo trigger, then the blindness won't matter. We just brought it to death's door. Let's see if the fire will kill it. And it did.
Problems have their solutions, even the big ones.
It was a good start for us for today. The loathing whispers. And we need to move on. We're gonna go once again for the battle here. How many? We would get 3 candles of hope. Okay. Great. So after the lair, we have an assistance encounter. And we have to go for another battle. We can't go for the Hero Shrine because there's another Hoarder. Then we have caches, another battle, maybe an assistance encounter, and then Oblivion's Rampart. Okay, so lots of battles. The lair might not be the best idea. At least not advancing too far into it. Once again, the leopard does not want to fight for some odd reason. Is he like peaceful or something? Does he have a trait? We can't see it within the battle. We got elite enemies, unfortunately. Hypochondria. No, he does not have a quirk. At least not that I can tell. Doesn't have a quirk that would say that. That he would want to flee battles. We'll do a duelist advance here. Maybe we can take out this ordained goat. That would be lovely. On one side I can do Abyssal Artillery, but I believe it is better if we just try to weaken it. Two Beast of Burdens attack. We'll do it with stand here. I guess Wicked Slice, we might kill this goat. And we managed to do it. Two enemies left. Let's see, smokescreen is one thing. We don't have a skill that pushes us back. And I will just have to walk. The goat might push us again. Nope. What do I do now? Do I do Solemnity or do I just straight up attack? Let's do Solemnity, make sure that our stress is low. We'll do Demon's Pool to clear that corpse, make sure he doesn't eat anything. I can do an Abyssal Artillery on the goat, sure, that is beautiful. And throw a bomb here. Great. What should I do? I'll do a point blank shot just because of the proximity to the Lord there. And because he has a combo trigger and we can go through it, well, at least we tried. And we weakened him, which is better than nothing. Good, the goat is dead. And now all that is left is the Lord. And he's down as well. Things are going well at the moment. Low stress, everything's fine. We gained.
The loathing festers.
A trinket that provides us with 25 resistance to stun and 50 to movement skills, and that is great for the leper. The leper being pushed back is very difficult to work with. Okay. How do we remove the stress from the arsonist? That is an interesting question. To which I have no answer at the moment. And we need to go towards the lair. At least on these paths, we really did not have any kind of road battles, which reduced some of our stress.
This will not be easy.
They are very close to forming a bond here. One away.
Steel yourself. The hulking horror inside.
Now let's see what the lair easily has. I will definitely focus on the maid to begin with. I mean, the goats are bad as they are, but we don't need them to be buffed by the maid with riposte and other skills. I will do withstand just so we can attract some of the damage. That's a 2 damage. Yeah, we're resisting now the pushes. That's a crit there. And Abyssal Artillery, beautiful. Almost ready. And she died. So we took down the maid and now maybe take down one of the goats. Well, very close. A combo tech token there. Ooh, what a bad crit. I really didn't want to do the bad pig. Yeah, I was always worried that this is something that this skill might do. Basically spread the fire to one of the corpses. But now at least we know for next time. It has been confirmed. I will do a weakening curse here. So the second goat has died, we have one more left. I will reduce stress because we can. I can do an open vein here for extra bleed. Let me do that. And I can throw a bomb, but I could do a smoke screen here, which provides it with a combo and a vulnerable. Okay. It feels like this is an interesting party. these two can put combo tokens, and even the occultist can. Which makes them very open to our leper. Do I want to advance here? What was it in the last battle? There was meats, right? We'll do another advance here. Unyielding enemies, 33% death doors resistance. That is not great. Abyssal artillery or weakening curse. Let's do a weakening curse here. And I will throw. I can throw a bomb on the Lord, which will spread around. No, let's focus on the mate to begin with. That's a 5 crit with another 5 damage. We get some blight. Well, no, we just got some stress. Okay. That attack was not what I expected, I guess. Fist of Burden might pull the occultist, but that is okay with me. 7 to 14 chance that we will hit the mate. Not 7 to 14 chance, 50% chance for 7 to 14 damage. 10 to the flock, that is a block and a riposte, if I remember correctly, 2 ripostes even. Then I'm going to spread the damage here from the Lord to the Maid. I could do a point blank shot, but there's no real reason to. Took down the Maid. And we're gonna do it stand. We'll attract the damage that we get from the goat. And also maybe the Lord will. Feeding time. Okay, so it ate the goat. What do I do now? Let me do a demon school on the Lord. I will throw a bomb on the Lord as well.
An unavoidable end.
Okay. I can steal. Let's see what happens here. So we're gonna do highway robbery, which destroys 2 positive tokens. I wonder, in this situation, does the goat still riposte? If not, this is an amazing skill. It didn't. Okay. Well, that is an amazing skill then. I'm just gonna do this, the weakening curse. A battering ram on the occultist, okay. With her. Let me do the ransack here. I can do a duelist advance, and I will do that. I got a blight there. But I also got, I think I also got a disease? No, we resisted the disease, that is good. Let's see. Thought we would hit the Lord, but it didn't happen. Tongue lashing, what's that? It gave the straw, the goat some strength. Still didn't kill it, the goat died. That is good. And let's see if a wicked slice does the job. It did. Yeah, there's not enough here. We'll escape.
In this world, wealth is worthless without purpose.
I don't think the second battle was really worth all that much. I was trying to get closer to the boss and see if maybe something happens, but it did not. Now Bonnie has a lot of stress, and they're just one away from forming a bond. I would have really hoped that we can do something there. Don't know if we can now. But let us see. So she's gaining more stress because fear of Gentry? We will do a duelist advance to begin with.
Bravo.
A beautiful crit. And then I am going to go with a bomb. Good, at least we're resisting movement skills. I am going to go with Weakening Curse here. And one of the Lost Souls is dead. Now let us hit the secondary Lost Soul and they're out.
But effective.
Now he will have a chance to eat, I believe. We can do a smoke screen on him. Let me do a smoke screen as well, reducing his chance to hit. Yeah, inhuman appetites. Well, that still isn't a problem, to be honest. Let's get a lot of damage in. Another wicked slice here. Wait, Bonnie will throw the bomb. We brought the Lord on Death's Door, and I am going to try to pull him if possible. A demon's pull, let's see. At least we're gonna clear the corpse if nothing else, but we've killed it.
Pleasant in the extreme. This work
minus 3 initiative,
noble.
Plus 10 damage.
Necessary.
If I'm not mistaken, we got syphilis on Baldwin, meaning 25% max HP, and at the start of the combat, either weakness or vulnerable, 15% chance, or a 7% chance of going blind. At least it's at the beginning of the combat and it's not further in. He has 2 base initiative, which also means that I could give him this trinket of 10% extra damage. Sure. And let's give the resistance to Blight to someone else. Yeah, of course they're breaking their relationship here. What would be the odds of that not happening? Apparently they all agree with each other. We can lose some hope. No, let's gain some hope here. Inseparable.
It's of the same stone.
Okay.
Never one without the other.
Okay, that was good at least. Now the meltdown won't be the end of the world. They all want to go to the Hero Shrine. I am very sorry for you. But we have to avoid it. Because we cannot go to the Hoarder. We're getting at least 2 more hopes here with 3 more if we reach the end of the map. I mean, that is amazing. hastened enemies.
Steady yourself.
Yeah, but you missed. So close to a meltdown. But a meltdown is not the worst, at least not while you already have the relationships for. Let me take out the mongrel. I'm just gonna try to take out the dog before anyone else. Shell shock. She just got dazed. I will do an abyss artillery here. You can see that our health is not a problem in this. It's mostly the fact that we do not have a good way to stress relief. Beautiful work there.
A lesson taught is a lesson learned.
Now, I could throw another bomb. Or I could do cauterize. Let's do cauterize here. Cool. Only one left. I will do a weakening curse first of all. Get him this combo. I will do a wicked slice for the damage. And we're just gonna attack it. And that's it. Battle over. So much strength within this party.
Let it die.
If we had a way to relieve stress, I believe that this will be like an unstoppable combination.
Plague eaters, feeding on the tainted crop.
Okay. Once again, they agree with each other. A corpse, a lady, and one of these goats. What are we going to start with? I guess we'll throw a bomb, why not?
A slow dissection.
She will take some damage here.
End.
A mother's embrace. Okay. I can do one of these attacks, or I could do a weakening curse on the livestock. Let's just go with abyssal artillery here. I will also do a duelist advance on the lady, and she might be out of the game. Let's do withstand to attract some of the damage. And we'll see what else happens now. Another bomb. Or ransack. Let's throw another bomb. I will do another abyssal artillery, or let's throw a weakening curse on the goat. He might attack again. Or it might attack again. And then we can do a wicked slice. Sure. We took out that goat.
To finish this quickly.
And the lady. And that leaves the dinner cart, which might, yeah, go for the human appetites here for the healing and the extra skill. Let me do a purge here to at least clear the corpses, if nothing else. We have a taunt. I will do an open vein here for the bleed. I'm gonna throw a bomb. That's good damage over time. Got another repose there. There's some food here, but we do not care for it. I will work on Solemnity to reduce his stress. A beautiful crit there. And let's see if we can take it out. And we managed to do so.
Persistence will overcome even the greatest of threats.
Perfect. So now we have a healing combat item, 25% chance of blight. None of us do blight damage, which is unfortunate.
The loathing abates.
So we're gonna throw that away. Maybe even the one with the fires here. And now we're gonna go to the right.
Supplies this way. If you can make it.
Hail enemies, and we have two ghouls. That means that we are definitely going to go into a meltdown here. Steal a token? Sure, but it's probably better to do a duelist advantage just to have the riposte in.
Steady yourself. Oof.
A stun there, which is very bad. But what can you do? We'll just work on one of them at a time. Another stun. I will work on withstand here to attract future damage. So if I do a point blank shot here, a 14 damage, still far away. I could do either to attack him, do a weakening curse, let's do a vulnerability hex. It's not the damage that is the worst thing. Okay, that is good. She jumped in to attack. And how old that is for stress. Begins. Another skull toss, another stun.
Stupefied.
Another skull toss, and here comes the meltdown. And that brought us. Hateful
and callousness have claimed dominion here.
Envious.
Each covets what the other has.
I mean, part of it is good. But not all of it. Should I? Let's throw a bomb, why not? That's a 12 damage just there. He has been stunned. At least they work with each other. Thank you very much. And we had a double kill there. Which leaves us with only one of the ghouls. What do I do here? I guess not a whole lot, just try to put damage on this gravestone. Oof. So we're at death's door right now. I am going to do Solemnity. We are going to try to heal her. Well, at least that functioned. Another skull toss, let's see. Howl. Okay, so more stress. And even more stress. Yeah, this is going down and quick. Another ward reconstruction could work. It didn't allow us. Then I am just going to put a weakening curse. Ok, Okay, some stress heal. That is good. Do I attract the damage? Or do I start... Let's start working on taking his health down. Otherwise, we could be here until tomorrow, until they all go into a meltdown. Got vulnerable here. I will do a duelist's advance. Yeah. Horror is not great. I believe a smoke screen could help here if he goes blind, but he didn't. At least he missed. Yeah, now we're in a meltdown. It's not the worst one.
A little help impeccably timed.
There, we almost took it out. Okay, let's see, what can we do here? I'll throw a bomb, bring it to Death's door, that weakened it as well.
An unavoidable end.
I would love some stress heal. But we couldn't do it. Then... onwards we go. We're about to go to the cache. We have healing items. Probably should start using them. But yeah, now we have the cache. Then we have another two battles, a road battle, another resistance encounter. And then an assistance. Let's see, what did we get here? Some stuff seems good. Good, the mold. We have a lot of reaches here. Let's remove these. Also these. We need to drop two more things. What are the chances that we would go in another shroud? I guess I'll throw the bandages away. They all have trinkets. And we'll throw some relics away. Okay, road battles, here we come. Yeah, we're getting even more negative bounter. If we make it to the next team, I'll be super happy.
Bravo.
Okay, there's a crit there. Let's throw a bomb.
A slow dissection. An unavoidable end.
Beautiful crit. Envious. Made her blind. Great stuff. Song of Shadows. So he went stealth. One of the lost souls perished. And we have just one more here. Now what I'm thinking is I'll do Solemnity. We will do a point blank shot here. With Bonnie, she has another meltdown here, which broke the relationship between her and the leper. But I am thinking about doing Heartlight because, well, we missed. But I was hoping that I could hit the urchin, doesn't matter because the occultist hit him anyway. Got some stress reduction there. Let's just take it out.
A lesson taught.
Okay, all things considered, Our relationships are broken right now, but other than that, it's not the worst, right? We're not in the worst situation that we've ever been in. We just need to heal our party. What do we want to do? So he wants to fight. They want to avoid fighting. Let's have them avoid fighting then. And with you, I say we'll go this way. We're going to the assistance encounter. See what we receive. We'll receive some hope, hopefully. And then we have another encounter and we've reached the inn. Where we're going to heal and prepare for the next step. Their honor.
Have you?
Okay. We don't get anything because only they have decisions and they all want to go. I mean, 6 darkness, that means that we are about to fight. You can't say that we didn't try. Hastened enemies, they act first. Great. He has a crit there. Ooh. An 8 crit. Ooh. Ouch. That hurts a lot. I could destroy 2 positive tokens. But let's do dualist advance here. At least we're getting some positive tokens of our own. And let me drag this thing to the front. We didn't manage to do anything there, but at least we can throw a bomb. We'll spread the fire. It didn't. I am going to attract some of the damage. Whenever there's a single attack, at least. Flash Weaving, this is the heal, okay. Nocturne Commune, this one is the crit. And what will you do? Hollow Vessel, that is fine. Let's see if we can do a point blank shot. We've missed. More stress. That's a meltdown. What can I do now? I could bandage. Let's bandage him up. Then we will do another bomb here in the back. I will throw a healing on the highwayman, and then we're doing abyssal artillery. What do I do with you? I guess I'll do solemnity. Maybe I'll do medicinal hurts first. And then we could do, as I said, solemnity for the stress. I don't know if you can hear the neighbors. Machine. I'm guessing they're drilling holes or something into the walls. A warship. Nocturnal Commune again. What does this do now? Exaltation. Oof. Tough battle here. I will do another duelist advance. Probably on you it's the good idea. Try to get the evangelist somehow. Then I will throw another bomb. Didn't manage to hit there, unfortunately. I will get out of death's door. And we were going to do an abyssal artillery here. Okay, the altar is dead at least. That is a victory in itself. Now I am going to attack the cardinal. Just because he had the combo. Yeah, that is a lot of damage. Entropic stars. Once again, Death's Door. Man, these guys hate each other a lot.
A little help, impeccably timed.
Oof. Oof. Sure. Let's throw more bombs here. Ward reconstruction, please. We even got a crit on it. Now what do I do? I could do a point blank shot trying to get a 7 to 9 damage, but that doesn't seem as useful as trying to get a bleed on the cardinal. Sure, I think the better idea here is just to focus on the cardinal. Worship for the heals. Worship apparently removes their damage over time too. Once again, another meltdown. Yeah, if we make it through all this, it is going to be an amazing feat.
Bravo!
Bravo, Highwayman, with that crit! Ward reconstruction could be something, but let's do abyssal artillery here because we were guaranteed a crit. She will take a lot of... Well, she didn't take the damage yet, apparently. I'm gonna try once again to hit the cardinal. We've missed. We keep getting a lot of problems. But we're out of Death's Door.
Steady yourself.
Yeah, someone will die here. If not during this battle, during the next.
Cruelty. Oof. Callousness have claimed dominion here.
Yeah. Something had to give. Throw another bomb. Ward reconstruction. Or do I do this? Well, it doesn't do a whole lot. Let's at least do ward reconstruction. Trying to keep her out of Death's Door. I can do Solemnity. Let me do that. But of course, this gives her the chance to heal him, which also gives him the power to attack the entire party. Yeah. Once again at Death's Door, more meltdowns. And a relationship is tested. What are they? They are suspicious.
Narrowed eyes, muttered threats.
What is this, Martyr? Minus one stress when self at Death's Door. Okay. Cauterize would happen only on him. Let us do... I will try the ransack.
And carelessness, hallmarks of the unprepared.
I mean, I can't think of anything else except for trying to just keep ourselves out of Death's Door somehow, in the hopes that we would get to the next battle, maybe? withstand. I could do withstand, but maybe I should have just taken the Evangelist out first. Yeah, probably that would have been the best idea there. Our party is really trying to survive this. Sure. Let's see if we can bother the Evangelist for a while. Ward reconstruction, we'll do this on the first line once again.
Suffering.
Okay, at least their relationship has improved. We are at Death's Door with you, but I can at least heal, cure, and I will do a chop trying to get, let's get the Cardinal. That's a 9 damage there. That worship again. Yeah, definitely should have taken out the Evangelist. That was probably my biggest mistake during this battle.
Once again,
the Occultist is out.
Terrible precipice.
She hasn't died yet, but she has a meltdown. And I will heal her. I am going to push till the very end. If we can make it out of this, maybe we can run home with a bit more hope.
Of the unprepared.
Okay, he's still here. I even had... No, I didn't have potions anymore. Okay. Ransacking. Suspicious gave her vulnerability. Trying to attack him.
Fatigue.
Hollow vessel. So that was the only attack he could do. What is she going to do? Worship. It is one of those things where you know you're dead. I was just really struggling, thinking and hoping. And we failed. How quickly the tables turned. But it was a good goal. I mean, I really tried to get as much hope as I could. In the end, we leave with only 10. If we would have made it to the next inn, it would have been so beautiful for us. But hey, that's how the game goes sometimes. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. We learn, we get better, and we try again. Until tomorrow, I hope you have enjoyed this episode. Thank you very much for watching, and I wish you all to have a wonderful day.